Hello, in this video I will show you a quick demo on our OBM3 tool, which is currently based on using Excel sheets. And the tool actually consists of a number of files, and I'll show you now how to use the structure of the tool and how to use it in doing your OBM3 assessments and improvements. Actually, many of the questions I receive from clients about this tool mainly are related to the OBM3 model itself or how to do assessments. But I want to highlight here that this is not the concern here of this video. I want to explain to you about the OBM3 model itself or how to do assessments. I'm assuming you already know that. And the tool is here to help you to automate the process and to do the assessment, perform the project. I'm not going to explain how to use the model or how to do assessments, but only how to apply this tool in performing your assessments. Okay. First, when you open the files of the tool, you will receive here a security warning from Microsoft, from Excel itself, telling you macros have been disabled because all the programming of the tool is using macros programming in Excel. So you need here to enable this content so that you can use the tool and the programming of the tool. And you will find a signature, a digital signed signature from us associated with all our files. So please check here it's signed by us and enable this content. And because we have many files here, I have 10 files, because the assessment of OBM3 is based on 9 roles, and we have the 9 roles plus the main file, which is the aggregation file of all scores from all roles. So here you will find I have opened here all files, so they are visible here for me from within Excel itself from the switch windows button. You can find all open files, and it's important here to note that you need to place all files in the same place on your hard disk, anywhere on your hard disk, but you need to be under the same directory together in the same place, because this is how they are referenced in the code. So anywhere on your PC, but in the same place. And you can switch from one file to another simply by clicking here. For example, I want to go to the leadership assessment file, and here I can see the leadership file is open. And the structure of the all files is similar. Here you can find only questions related to this role, because this is a leadership role file. You will find only questions related to the leadership role. Here you will find the tab for organization enablers questions and the project standardize, project measure, project improve. There is here no questions related to project control for the leadership role, so this tab is not shown here, although it was shown in the main file. The main file includes all tabs actually. So here in this main file, we have organizational enablers and project standardize, measure, control, improve. And the program the same for stages, and the portfolio same for stages. And then we have the result steps for OEs and for project, for program, and for portfolio, and overall aggregated results. Here you will find the results both in English and in Arabic language. And this one the first one is in English, and the second one is in Arabic language for all results. The overall tab includes both languages as well. Okay, and in the main file only we'll find the tab of score calculation, which is actually the main interface for aggregating all the scores after you have done your scoring in all other files related to each role. So after you complete scoring in all of these files related to all roles included in the assessment, you will go to the main tab and go to the score calculation sheet, and here Sorry, we'll go to the main file and you will go to the score calculation sheet. And here you will find these weights associated to each of the nine roles are not changeable. These are fixed weights. And you cannot change these weights because we wanted the results of using the tool to be comparable between all users of the tool. So we will not allow each user to change the weights so that the results are comparable. But here you can manually assign scores for each of the roles. For example, here you can assign the role leadership from 0 to 3. And here you will find the final score. But this is a manual calculation. You only use that if you want to change the automatic calculations. Because here you have the option to do auto-calculate, the button at the end here. You have the auto-calculate. Auto-calculate button enables you to automatically aggregate scores from all the sheets of role-based sheets, automatically aggregated and collected in the results tabs of the main file. Okay, so the auto-calculate button is the easiest option for you. But if you want to change something, or for example, if it's not working for you, you have here the option to do the scoring manually. And this should be used with caution, and because it's error prone, if you do something manually, you may miss some scoring, or you may do wrong scoring. And this portion is for exclusion or inclusion of scoping. If you include project management, yes or no. Program management, yes or no. And portfolio management, yes or no. And this also only applicable for the OE step. Because the OE step, we have OEs applicable to each domain. So here we have OEs applicable to portfolio, program, project. We have also OEs applicable to portfolio only, for example, and so on. So OEs are applicable to some domains. This scoping is for the inclusion or exclusion of OEs questions in the OE step. But mainly, you don't need to do that if you simply answer the questions related to the domain you want to assess. If you want to assess project management only, you will set this one to no, and this one also to not no. So excluding or excluding program and the portfolio management, and we're using only project management. And you need to answer the questions related to project management in all files included in the tool. You will find that you only have enabled cells for the scoring. And the only rows visible here is for the role you are working on. This is the leadership role, and we have only rows of the sheet related to the questions of leadership role. The questions that are not applicable to the leadership role are not visible here. You here put the score of each question, and if you want to exclude this question, set it to not applicable. Not applicable here, simply set this to no, and it will set score to zero here. Change it back to yes, and it will be active here to set the score if it's included or not included. And you can see scoring is color-coded. If it's a full mark, then it's green. If it's a zero, then it's red. If it's one or two, then it will be yellow. And you will do the same for all questions. And here you can add your notes, if you have any notes related to any question. Also note here that the role-based sheets, the role-based files, are only for the role as a whole. For the role as a whole, meaning that it's not for each one. For example, the project manager's role, it's the sheet for the role as a whole, meaning that you aggregate or take average of all scores for individual project managers. If, for example, you have 5 or 10 project managers in the assessment, you simply take the average of their scoring and include that final average here in the project manager's file. And this represents the score of the role, the project manager role, not for individuals. Okay, so simply you take average of all scores of individual project managers and include it here for the scoring of the project manager role. And you do the same for all roles available here. And again, here you can see only tabs applicable to the project manager role. So here you can see the program tabs or the portfolio tabs, and this is the results tabs only if all related tabs are visible in questions. So you don't see the project results tab if one of these stages of SMCI is missing. We will not include the results tab in role based files. For example, here in the line managers, for example, we have only the improved stages of the three domains, and you can't see the results tabs of any domain because the questions are not complete to build the results. So you can see the results tab only if the four stages are included for a specific domain. So back to the main file. After I finish scoring of all role-based files, I go here to the score calculation tab in the main file, and already I have my scoping. I click the auto calculate button. The auto calculate button will open all of these files one by one and aggregate scores, and it will tell you as it's progressing, it will show you messages about we have finished. For example, the leadership role, we have finished HR role, continue and so on, and you click yes, no, until it's finished. After it's finished, you will see the results here in the results tab. This is the OE results. See here, for example, 100%, and you can copy the report from the all results tab, include this copy report button. This copy report button takes a screenshot from the whole report, and you can paste it in Word file or in another Excel file. So once you click copy, you can go to the any other file and click paste, and you will find the report pasted in this file. And the overall here shows the overall maturity of organizational project management as a whole, including project, program, portfolio according to selected scope. It will show you achieved, not achieved as an overall percentage, and then the project project management domain results. You will see the overall project for project management domain, overall maturity score, and then by SMSCI stage, and then by process group, by knowledge area, and by individual process, and then also the score for each best practice in SMCI stages for each process, and number of achieved best practice, and again the copy report button. The standard here for project management is the latest version of BIMBOK, which is version 6. Until the recording of this video, it was version 6. For programs and portfolios, we are using second edition, not third edition, because this is process-based, and you can see that third edition is not process-based. So I'm including here the second edition of program and portfolio management. And for program management, we include both activities and the processes, not only processes. We include activities and the processes. And you can see that in the assessment questions and in the results as well. So I hope this is sufficient to understand how the tool is used. And if you have any questions, please contact us. And you can find also the user guide in the brochure of the tool on our website. Thank you.